Hey everybody, Nick here. I wanted to jump on because I saw a really cool tutorial from Deb Ashby, who is a Microsoft MVP and an amazing trainer. If you want to know anything about Excel, PowerPoint, Word, you need to follow her and look at her online courses too. I did her pivot table course in Excel, and if you work in Excel at all, you will want to take that pivot table course. It will blow your mind. So I'm gonna link to that above and below. Please go follow Deb over on LinkedIn. The tutorial that she was offering was this little way that you could kiosk a few slides and then move into the rest of your slides as a presentation. So pretend you were in a conference center and maybe you were giving a presentation, but people were filing in the room and you wanted the first three slides to sort of run on a carousel loop in the background as people entered, and then you wanted to move into your presentation. So the way that Deb accomplished this was by recording a custom show for those first three slides, and then she would escape out of those when she was ready and then move into the rest of her presentation, which I thought was a really cool way to do it. Somebody had asked me how to do this a few months back, and I was looking at the ribbon, at the slideshow tab on the ribbon, and trying to figure out how could this be accomplished without having to escape your slides and then move back into your presentation. So you could kind of do it in one sort of a nice, smooth running loop. So this is how I thought about it. One of the cool things about PowerPoint is that there are 18,000 ways to slice a tomato. There's so many ways that you can accomplish the same thing with different little tricks, hacks, and workarounds. So that's one of the reasons why I love working in PowerPoint. So let's go over here to my presentation slides. I'm gonna go down here and click on the slide sorter view right here so we can see all of my slides. And let's just say I want to loop my first three slides, 1, 2, and 3, and then slides 4 through 14 are gonna be my presentation. So the first thing I'm gonna do, you don't have to do this step, but I wanted to show you how you can add sections to your PowerPoint slides. So this is a really nice way to kind of organize your slides as you go. Just put your cursor where you want to add the section. You're gonna right click and then say add section. And here's where you can type. I'm gonna call this my looped slides. And then between 3 and 4, I'm gonna right click and add a new section here. This is where my presentation slides start. This is just for me, my peace of mind on the back end keeps me nice and tidy and organized. So the first three slides here, I'm gonna go ahead and loop. Now in Deb's version, she recorded that custom show and she recorded the custom timings, but I'm going to use the transitions tab up here on the ribbon to automatically advance my slides. So I'm gonna go ahead and hold down shift and select all of the slides that I want to apply my automatic transition to. Go up to the transitions tab right here on the home tab. You will see this home tab right here. You're just gonna go right here to transitions and then go all the way to the right. You will see that it says on mouse click. So that just means that I'm going to click my mouse or click the tab key or the arrow key on my keyboard, and that will advance the slide. I'm going to unselect that box and I'm going to check after, and then I'm going to say 4 seconds over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this means that every single slide that I have applied this transition to will advance on its own every 4 seconds. So you can see that I have a custom transition applied right here. If you look on your slide sorter, you can see those little seconds, those minutes and those seconds and microseconds, or no, I guess it's seconds and minutes there. I guess we could do a really long slide if we wanted to do that. So you can see those little custom transitions applied there to your slides. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on 4, hold down shift all the way to 14, and I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna hide them. So you can hide these slides. We're going to go back up to these loop slides here. And I'm gonna go put this in slideshow mode just to test it out. Now what this should do is it should only loop my first three slides and it should keep on going on a loop. So let's see if it does that. Go down here, put it in slideshow mode, wait 4 seconds, and this next slide should advance to slide 2. There it does on its own. And then slide 3, and now the moment of truth, 4 more seconds, and we should see the first slide again. Yes, we do. Welcome to my presentation. Now you can hit escape and that will get us out of that loop. Now, the thing is, how do I get to my presentation slides when they are hidden? For some reason, if you create a hyperlink to those slides from one of the slides that is not hidden, it somehow, for some reason, disables that hide feature. So let me show you what I'm thinking about. What I'm gonna do here is on slide number 3, let's go to slides number 3. I'm gonna double click this. I'm gonna put any shape over it. And what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna draw a rectangle and I'm gonna fill the slide with this rectangle. I'm gonna cover the whole slide and even go off the slide. Now, we need to go ahead and format this box, this rectangle, so that there's no fill in the shape. So there's no fill there. So when I put this in slideshow mode, you're not gonna see the border and you're not gonna see the shape. What I'm gonna do is apply a hyperlink to this shape. So we're gonna right click and click on link right here. When I click on link, that says you get a few different options here, but I'm going to, instead of an existing file or web page, I'm going to say place in this document. Now I'm going to link to another slide in this document, and I'm not going to link to 1, 2, or 3. I'm going to link to slide number 4. We're going to push OK. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select that box. I'm going to copy it, Control C to copy. I'm going to put that also on slide number 2, and I'm going to put that also on slide number 1. Now, as my slides are looping, as people are walking in the conference room, I will go ahead and hover my mouse over whatever slide that is. I'm going to click once, and it should take me right to slide number 4, which will begin my presentation. So let's go ahead and test this out. I'm going to put my cursor here on slide 1. We're going to go ahead and put it in slideshow mode, and we'll see what happens. Let's go ahead and let this advance. We'll wait the 4 seconds, and then slide 1 will go to slide 2. We'll wait another 4 seconds. Slide 2 will go to slide 3. And now this should go back to slide 1, but whatever slide I'm on when I want to start my presentation, just hover your mouse over. You can see my mouse right here has turned into that little hand, and I'm just going to go ahead and click. And now it has taken me to my slide number 4. And now with my keyboard or my mouse, I can now advance the slides. For some reason, even though these slides are hidden, when I've created that in slide hyperlink to a place in the document, it goes to those and it disables the hidden slides for some reason. So we can also go all the way to the end. Let's go all the way to thank you. If I needed to go backwards, I could do that. And I thought maybe if I went backwards all the way to the point of going to the first 3 slides, it wouldn't let me. Let's see if we go back, and it does now. If I go all the way back to the first 3 slides, that's the limitation. So if I tab back over the first 3 slides, all it's going to do is loop for me those first 3 slides. I can't do anything, but the way to do that to get that fixed is just to go ahead and click again, and now you can go back to your presentation slide. So if you're going to jump around after you've given the presentation, you just have to make sure that you don't end up back on one of those first 3 slides. And then if you do end up back on one of those first 3 slides, just make sure to click to get out of it, and then you can go back into your presentation slide. So Deb, let me know in the comments what you think of this little trick. And I also actually want to know if this works on your end, because at first I was thinking this might be kind of like a gremlin or some sort of glitch in PowerPoint, because I didn't think if a slide was hidden, it should be able to be shown in slideshow view. But apparently putting that little hyperlink there actually disabled that feature for some reason for me. So let me know in the comments if it works for you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. Can't wait to see y'all next time.